Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 9th, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we all cross the finish line together. First article of interest. Iraq factions reach deal to save government, end protests. PM urges return to normal life. Baghdad, AFP, Reuters. Iraq's political class has reached a consensus to protect Prime Minister Adel Abdel Mahdi's government against protests sweeping the country's capital and south for weeks, sources told Agence France-Presse on Saturday, November 9. The agreement is the product of a series of meetings, including gatherings led by Major General Qasem Soleimani, commander of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps Foreign Operations Arm, the Quds Force. He has met with top leaders in Najaf and Baghdad, piling on the pressure to close ranks around Abdel Mahdi. A source present at some of those meetings told AFP Soleimani had met with populist cleric Miqtada Sadr, who had vocally backed the protests, and Mohammad Ridha Sistani, the son of Iraq's top Shiite cleric, Grand Ayatollah Ali Sistani. Those meetings resulted in an agreement that Abdel Mahdi would remain in office, the source said. Public anger erupted into demonstrations on October 1 against corruption and a lack of jobs, escalating into calls for the entire ruling system to be overturned. But he has become the target of protesters' rage, accused of commandeering a bloody crackdown that has left nearly 300 dead since protests broke out. Another source said political factions agreed this week to move forward on reforms if the premier and government stayed in place. Most of the heads of major blocs agreed in a meeting to keep Adel Abdel Mahdi and maintain power in exchange for reforms on corruption and constitutional amendments, said the source, a high-ranking member of a party that was represented at the gathering. They agreed to end the protests with any means possible and to reopen the bridges and shuttered streets, the official said. Overnight, security forces began clearing out protest camps in Baghdad, the port city of Basra and the holy city of Karbala. Abdel Mahdi said on Saturday that while protests were important in bringing about political reform, life in the country must now be allowed to return to normal. The protests have helped and will help pressure political groups, the government, to reform and accept change. However, continuing protests must allow for a return to normal life, which will lead to legitimate demands being met, Abdel Mahdi said in a statement. In a nod to protesters' demands, he acknowledged that political parties had made many mistakes in the past 16 years, since the U.S.-led overthrow of Saddam Hussein in 2003. Security forces continue to use live fire against demonstrators, in addition to tear gas canisters and stun grenades fired directly at protesters. Abdel Mahdi, who announced a spate of reforms during the first wave of protests last month, added that new electoral reforms would be announced in the coming few days. He said the government and the judiciary would continue to investigate all deaths relating to the protests and pursue all who assault, kidnap, or arrest outside the law. Next article of interest. Al-Hadithi. Any option other than reform will have serious consequences and the government aims for radical reform. 9 November 2019 8:45:50 Baghdad. Prime Minister Adel al-Mahdi spokesman Saad al-Hadithi said the Iraqi government was working on radical reform in the country. Any option other than reform in Iraq will have serious consequences, Hadithi said. The popular movement has helped the government push forward reform of the front, he said. He said that the government puts legislation for laws aimed at radical reform in Iraq. Next article of interest. Islamic banking is a guarantee of a secure profit sharing. Saturday 9 November 2019 Baghdad Shukran al-Fatlawi. Islamic banks have become a relatively new hinge for many economies around the world, with a size of more than $1 trillion internationally. All bank accounts, where interest or interest is not paid to current account holders on their deposits or savings account holders on their savings. The reason for this is that money has no implicit value, it is just a tool for barter. Riyad al-Zalmi spoke about the characteristics that characterize Islamic accounts, saying that current accounts become compliant with Islamic law when they are not paid or collected interest on accounts payable or receivable in general, and above the minimum balance. Open accounts. Unlike conventional accounts, current Islamic bank accounts cannot be exposed, so customers should always make sure they have enough money to cover their monthly expenses. He pointed out that the primary profit method in Islamic banks is focused on trade, so banks can trade in investments compliant with the Islamic Sharia through funds deposited by customers, and then share the risks and profits with the client in order to ensure that the profits are appropriately shared. Separating banks' Islamic bank between shareholders' equity and customer deposits in order to ensure that profits are properly shared, a concept that is consistent with the principle of equity Islamism. Savings. Regarding savings in Islamic accounts, he said, these accounts operate on the same principle, that the money saved in the account cannot reap any interest because that is forbidden by law. Instead, the target profits are provided to savers instead of interest, and that is why profit rates are based on Sharia-compliant accounts rather than rates benefit. Banks then use the funds deposited to invest in commercial activities in order to obtain the above target profits. Like conventional savings accounts, customers can choose either a fixed profit target that is usually found in a time deposit account or an accessible savings account that they can access. Drag it in any time. Compatible savings. Anyone can open a current account or a Sharia-compliant savings account. Islamic banking is open to all, whatever their religious faith. In fact, some non-Muslims prefer the principles and values of Islamic banking over conventional banking. Banks cannot use the invested funds to do any business that would finance any activities that are considered prohibited or harmful socially. Profit rate. Finding the best Islamic bank account should be the first step to compare all available Islamic accounts, he said. If there are any hidden fees, there may be fees to transfer money or to withdraw money from an ATM from a bank that does not have an agreement with your bank. Next article of interest. Compliance in the banking system. Saturday, 9th November 2019. Haider Kazem Adhari. Banks are committed to applying the most important international and domestic standards of compliance, setting policies and procedures and organizing an appropriate manual with a dynamic approach to the situation. The function of the compliance section is to ensure that banks comply with all laws, regulations and circulars issued by the Central Bank of Iraq and government entities and in outside Iraq as international institutions, which determine the provision of advice and guidance and monitor and report to the Compliance Committee and the Board of Directors on Compliance and instructions to monitor compliance in Article 71. The Compliance Department has a scope of work to determine the organizational structure of the compliance unit and the roles and responsibilities of its employees and the section. It is relevant to the compliance function, ensuring appropriate oversight and periodic reporting on the work of the compliance unit within the bank. It is also keen to send quarterly reports to the central bank in a timely manner and is keen to follow up the work of all sections in the specified bank and know the work of those sections properly, and the section reviews the files opened in the bank to ensure the correct implementation of the policy. Know your customer. Key. Compliance is responsible for monitoring and directing bank credits and protecting the public deposits in the bank, as well as protecting the rights of shareholders. The bank is keen to participate in all courses held at the Central Bank and the Iraqi Banks Association. The Compliance Department shall follow up daily with the money laundering unit of the Islamic World Bank to ensure the safety of the funds entering the bank and take due diligence procedures. E-funds to prevent the use of the bank's activities for money laundering and terrorist financing. Next article of interest. Parliament ends discussion of proposed abolition of fiscal privileges for officials. 1708, 9th November 2019, Baghdad. On Saturday, the Parliament concluded a report and discussed the proposal to abolish the financial privileges of officials. The Reporter, Information, The House of Representatives. Today, The report and discussion of the proposed law to cancel the financial privileges of officials in the Iraqi state. The House of Representatives, on Saturday, its 12th session chaired by Mohammed Halbousi and the presence of 232 deputies, while he finished reading the laws of elections and unified retirement. It is scheduled to witness the meeting today, the second reading of the draft law of the Reconstruction Council, and discuss the second reading of the proposed law to abolish the financial privileges of officials in the state. Next article of interest. Parliament finishes reading the pension law and sets the pension to 600,000 minimum. 1643, 9th November 2019, Baghdad, the House of Representatives, on Saturday, read the Unified Retirement Law and opened the door for discussion as a prelude to its adoption, while the law included a pension limit of 600,000 dinars minimum. The MP for the Conquest Mohammed Karim /information/the House of Representatives finished the second reading of the Unified Retirement Law and opened the door for discussion before the vote. He added that the law set the pension at 600,000 dinars as a minimum, noting that the law granted the right to apply for retirement for those who have served 15 years in government departments provided that he is not less than 45 years old. He explained that there are disagreements are going on some paragraphs of the law, noting that among them include the dissolved organs of the former regime of pension. Next article of interest. After closing for 10 days, IMCA's report reopens. November 9, 2019, Baghdad, an official at the port of Umkaiser for commodities near Basra in southern Iraq, resumed operations in the port after a suspension of nearly 10 days. After the protesters closed its entrance in order to pressure the government to fulfill their demands to improve living conditions and combat rampant corruption in various state agencies. The official said, according to Reuters, that all the berths work on Saturday, adding that the ships began to unload their cargo. The port of Umkaiser receives shipments of grain, vegetable oils and sugar to a country heavily dependent on food imports. On Sunday, demonstrators in the province of Basra cut off major roads leading to the ports of Umkaiser, commercial, Kral Zubair, industrial, and Abu Flus, intended for the reception of public goods, a fertilizer plant, liquid gas terminal and gas power station. Other governorates have also seen roads leading to oil fields and land border access, particularly with Kuwait. Since October 25, Iraq has been witnessing a wave of escalating anti-government protests, the second of its kind after 2 weeks before. The protesters had demanded at the beginning of the demonstrations to improve public services, provide jobs, and combat the rampant corruption in the various state agencies, before raising the ceiling of their demands to overthrow the government, after the army and security forces used excessive violence against them, which was recognized by the government, and promised to hold officials accountable about him. Protests in recent days have taken a new turn by cutting off major roads leading to a number of oil fields, ports and land ports, particularly with Iran. The Iraqi government says the continued closure of energy facilities, ports and ports, causing financial losses estimated at billions. Next article of interest. Parliament calls for budget quickly and Halbousi rejects excessive violence. 9 November, 2019, Baghdad. Parliament Speaker Mohammed al-Halbousi called on the Iraqi government to send the budget quickly. Halbousi said in a meeting on Saturday, he directed the Secretariat of the Council to address the Secretariat of the Council of Ministers to emphasize the speedy dispatch of the federal budget. Speaking about the fall of wounded during the breaking up of a sit-in in Baghdad, Halbousi said, "We categorically reject the use of excessive violence against demonstrators." He added, "Speaker of the House of Representatives will launch a national initiative bringing together the three authorities, academics, religious references and social spectrum to address the problems and the development of popular demands for the rights and duties necessary for the authorities to implement and involve the United Nations according to a timetable and serious work." Next article of interest. Saleh discusses with French ambassador international support to promote reforms in Iraq. 9th November 2019 1448 Baghdad. President of the Republic Barham Saleh discussed with French ambassador to Iraq Bruno Hubert international support to promote reforms in Iraq. A statement issued by his office, which received Euphrates News, that during the meeting discussed international support to strengthen security, stability and reforms in the country, as well as ways to improve bilateral relations between the two countries in the interest of the two friendly peoples. Next article of interest. U.S. newspaper, Iraq may become the focus of Chinese aspirations in the Middle East. 1611, 9th November 2019 Alma Alamein News. China sees Iraq as a key element in the success of its global development strategy known as the One Belt, One Road Initiative in the Middle East, a report said Saturday. But Beijing's economic expansion in the region could force Baghdad to seek a new balance in its relations with China and the United States. Beijing's presence in the Middle East has been growing over the past decade, making it more quickly a trading partner for many countries in the region, and its growing economic strength will attract the attention of other players in the region, the report said. Region, like the United States. China's goals in the Middle East revolve around energy, infrastructure, trade and investment, and with owning Iraq world's fifth largest oil reserves and a geopolitical strategic location, China considers Iraq the key missing piece in its plans to control trade throughout Europe and Asia, as well as being a bridge between its shipping lanes and countries such as Israel, Turkey and the Gulf states. China is Iraq's largest trading partner, with trade between the two countries reaching nearly $30 billion last year. Likewise, Iraq is China's second largest supplier of crude oil and China's fourth largest trading partner in the Middle East. The report pointed out that China's acquisition of Iraq in a single road project in One Belt is a big step towards its goal of gaining economic dominance in the Middle East. Has seen every region in the world has seen a significant decline in Chinese investment in construction projects except the Middle East and North Africa. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like and the subscribe button and check out the new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Be sure to tell them that the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.